Hey everybody, my name is John Green, and in this video, I'll be sharing with you how I took my salary from $19,000 a year to $120,000 a year by teaching myself how to learn networking concepts and ultimately how to pivot in the world of IT. Make sure to subscribe to the channel as I'll be posting networking tutorials and helpful tips that you can use to excel in your IT journey. So to share with you a little bit about my background, I'm from the United States. I was born and raised in Columbia, South Carolina. And in 2018, I was enrolled in a network certificate program where I was faced with a decision that ultimately set me on a path to pursue a career in IT. So in June of 2018, I was just graduating from my high school, W.J. Keenan, and I was currently working as a cashier making roughly $12 an hour. Now, that following August, I had enrolled in a year-long network certificate program where it was just networking. There were no math classes, no English classes. It was strictly Cisco routing and switching. And this is where I really learned the fundamentals of how things work in networking. But while I was in school and I was also working, I was offered the opportunity to work as a dispatcher for the local police department. And this position was gonna pay $18 an hour. I was making $12 an hour. And so I was And the raises for me being a cashier was like 25 cents to a dollar. And I'm doing the math in my head. I'm like, that's one, two, three, that's money. And I was really thinking hard about this decision because I was thinking about, you know, what's going to get me to my destination quicker. But ultimately, I ended up declining the position because I had already made up my mind that I was going to try to make things work and, you know, give finding a job in IT a shot. So turning down this decision, which really felt like my only other option to get me out of, you know, my current role, really forced me to take my learning at the network certificate program serious. I started really trying to understand the concepts, and I ended up using the material that I learned eventually to acquire my first certification, which was the CSINT at the time. So in June of 2019, towards finishing the certificate program, the professor had directed me to apply to an internship for a company that was partnered with the school. And he said all I needed was to get my resume created and just apply to the internship position on the company's website. And so my cousin, he was able to put me in contact with a person that I could call, and they would get me a professional looking resume created for just $50. And that was a lifesaver because I had no idea how I was going to make working as a cashier at my local grocery store and previous role at McDonald's look sexy on paper. So I did that. I submitted the role. Fast forward, I ended up landing a 3-month internship. This was for a junior network engineer role, which paid about $13 an hour, but it was 40 hours a week and it was paid biweekly. So that equated to about a little under $800 every 2 weeks. Now, it wasn't enough to, you know, move me out and cover all my expenses, not to mention it was only a 3-month position, but it was definitely a lot more than what I was making as a cashier at the time. So being that I wanted to be eligible for a position when I finished the internship, when I didn't have work that was assigned to me by the engineers that were my direct point of contacts, I was studying for my next certification, the CCNP. And the company thought I was doing a good job, so they ended up extending the internship for an additional 3 months. So I really kept studying, and I eventually saved up the money that I was making from the internship to test and pass my CCNP certification. Now, the certification costs $900, but it cost me $1,500 because I had to take two of the three parts twice because I failed. When the internship ended, I was issued a temp to hire position as a NOC analyst. This was still $13 an hour, but I was putting my application out there and I was still new to sort of navigating the world and I was just getting turned down left and right. So I was more than happy to soak up any opportunity to continue learning and getting hands-on experience. But in 2020, COVID hit. The company downsized and the position that I was in was no longer available. So in March of 2020, when the internship, the temp to hire position finally ended, I was confronted with the decision, and that was to go back to working as a cashier. And I decided that I knew the amount that I made as a cashier, it wasn't going to support the lifestyle that I wanted for myself or my family. And so ultimately, I made the decision to not go back to that role, which drove me to say, okay, it really gave me no escape. It was like, I gotta find a job in IT in order to keep this going. Thanks to the stimulus checks and unemployment, I was able to keep myself afloat during this time where I was without a job. During this time period, I was actively applying to jobs. I had to apply to and gotten turned down by over 100 companies, or at least 100 positions. however, I was learning. I was soaking up everything. During interviews, I was writing down the questions that I was asked, the ones that, I got right, I did good. The ones that I struggled with, I was even going online and Googling questions that I could have potentially been asked. And so I even created a script that I could use to answer a lot of these commonly asked questions regarding my background, which gave me insight sort of into, what I did and how to present myself when I was in these interviews. And lastly, I even prepared a few questions of my own. So rather than just showing up to an interview and splurging a whole bunch of, stuff about me, I was able to actually walk away with some information about the person that was actually interviewing me, which was very useful to be able to use that insights in future interviews. So how did I study during this time frame? So during this time, I already had the CCNP under my belt, but in my head, I really felt like I didn't know anything. So I wanted to go back and really cement everything that was covered in that exam so I really knew it at a fundamental level. I engaged in building my own like home projects. For example, I built my home network to really get me familiar and sort of wrap my hand around what all takes place. Whenever I had an interview for an upcoming job, I would look at the job description really, really clear, and I would see immediately like things that I didn't know. For some reason at the time, I thought that I needed to know 100% of everything that was on the application. So the things that I didn't know, I would immediately look into, figure out what they were, and try to study them a bit, not master them by no degree, but I wanted to get some basic familiarity. So if I got asked a question regarding that, and I'd be like, yeah, so that does this, I would have at least a basic understanding of how it would work in their environment. So September came around and my unemployment had dried up. I think it actually dried up in August. But thankfully I had some money saved up and I was able to use that to carry me a few more months. So luckily in November of 2020, I had a recruiter reach out to me. They came across my profile on LinkedIn and they offered me a contract role. So I interviewed for it, I went through the screening and I got accepted for the role. It was a contract position for a network engineer and it was paying $27 an hour. That was $50,000 a year. Now, at this time, I didn't know too much of the difference between a contract role versus a full-time role. At the time, I was just ecstatic to finally have had a job that was going to pay me at this higher rate, 40 hours a week. I was also eager to learn how things worked in IT from the standpoint of another company's perspective. So then in February of 2021, I was offered the opportunity to do some freelance work. All I needed to do was to clean up my resume, submit it. And at the time, I didn't really know much about independent contracting. One of the major things that I learned was you don't clock in like a 9-to-5. Instead, you get paid for the time that you put in during the assignment. But what's cool about this is that your hourly rate is usually a lot higher than if you were employed by the company directly. So for the first time, I was able to price myself for the work I did at $45 an hour. So here's the cool part. Fast forward about 6 months later, I began putting my resume out there and I landed a job offer and I was able to negotiate my salary referencing the hourly rate that I made while I was working as an independent contractor, which was that $45 hour rate. This ended up in me doubling my overall salary within a year of having that network engineer title. So one of the biggest lessons that I learned over this journey was to not be afraid to value what I do at a price that's higher than what I currently make. I switched my thinking to think of it as in terms of where I'd like to go rather than where I'm coming from. Well, that is the end of this video. I hope you found this story helpful towards your journey in IT If you at all found it helpful, go ahead and smash that like button and subscribe to the channel to stay tuned for future videos. As always, thanks for viewing, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.